Welcome to the first episode of Bites and Breaklights with Xian, featuring Hannah Glasby eating Bagel Broker.
Isn't it good?
The cornmeal on the outside, like the extra little crunch. Oh my god.
Crunchy cornmeal on the outside.
Because there's literally nothing worse than if you have a bagel that is not crunchy. Crunchy and creamy. I'll be back, the Bagel Broker.
Babel? Whatever.
We all know what you're talking about.
Whatever, Bagel Broker. You own my soul, Bagel Broker!
What do you reckon's going on in CBS right now?
Price is Right. I watch that at the gym.
Really?
The Price is Right.
I thought you watch food videos at the gym.
I do, but when I'm on the bike, I don't have a TV, and the TVs in front of me have their own thing on, and so usually it's The Price is Right, or what's that one with Wayne Brady?
Oh. I can picture it in my head. I can't for the life of me remember what the fucking name of it is, though. Some of those game shows.
Silly game show. People are just, like, so stoked to win, like,
$1,500. $1,500 is a lot of money.
Mm-hmm. Except you have to, like, dress in a costume, make a fool out of yourself.
You have to be overly excited. I mean, like, you're obviously overly excited because you're on TV and, like, you're winning money, possibly. But, like,
you're not from here if you're going there.
Put it that way. That's exactly right.
I think, like, you plan your vacation around, like, we are going to be on The Price is Right.
Could you imagine? Could you imagine if you'd never grown up in Los Angeles? Actually, I can relate to this, but I've been here for such a long time, it doesn't feel like that anymore. But imagine growing up in a different place and, like, coming to L.A.
Mm-hmm.
And going to those things. That's, like, a pinnacle in your life. That's something you remember forever.
I mean, I remember my first time my mom brought me up here. I can't remember where she took me to. I just remember driving on Hollywood Boulevard and being like, oh my god, this is where they do all the movie premieres. I was like, freaked out. My mom was like, yes, aspire. Go to your auditions. Be mini-me.
Look where you are, fucking, what, 16 years later? 15 years later? Somewhere in there?
16 now.
We're gonna have a party.
Old lady!
We're gonna have a party at 20.
Oh my god. That's crazy. That terrifies me.
Hold it. You'll be
4 years from now. Don't talk about how old I'm gonna be, bitch.
You'll be 26 in 4 years.
Yes, I'll be 26 in 4 years.
So.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Yeah.
It's crazy to think about.
We're so young.
We're so young.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, I was talking to the makeup artist yesterday about the fact that it's like, it's just really interesting to me. It's like, I remember like coming into this industry like, bright-eyed, bushy-tailed, and I was so happy, I was so excited. I was working with these people who were like, 5-10 years older than I was, and now it's, we are literally in that position, like going to jobs, and I'm working with these 17-year-old girls, and I'm just like, there's a part of me, it's like, fuck you. But then there's also a part of me, it's like, hold up, I was here at one point, and this is how I've grown to be able to be the model I am, so.
Other people being like, don't do that.
Or just leading by example, really, and just like showing, like, I mean, I learn a lot from other girls in terms of like how to hold myself and my work ethic and all that kind of stuff. No, there's a lot of shitty models out there.
Yeah, like, well, I just remember, like, being a kid and, like, being on some job, and I was just loud because I was scared, and it was,
overcompensating, like, you're really excited.
Totally overcompensating, and because, like, I'm a loud person to begin with, but when I'm uncomfortable in those situations where I feel like I have something I have to prove, I'm like, like all over the place, and just was so crazy. And this girl this one time was like, hey, you don't need to be so obnoxious. And I was like, ow, ew, rude. And then I was like, oh wait, She's right. She's super graceful and, like, amazing, and, like, I should really just grow up.
Yeah.
Thankfully.
It's like what you were saying the other day. It's like there's a line between, like, having a lot of energy and being really crazy and kind of overdoing it, overcomplicating sometimes, and then there's, like, still getting along with everybody and, like, being a fucking homie with everybody and like, having a great fucking shoot and being really excited about the fact that you're having a really good shoot, but there's, like, a line in for professionalism, I And
fuck
that just
this
comes
bagel.
Yeah, and that just comes what? That bagel's fucking stupid.
So, fuck this bagel! I wanna eat the whole thing.
Did you?
Mm-mm.
Why not?
It's
a bagel.
That's why.
That's why.
Because it's a bagel.
Mmm. Some booch.
Booch.
Booch to wash down. Does the rain let up a little bit?
Kombucha hiccup.
That is fucking delicious. We would like sponsorship for this, please. Because this is friggin' delicious. And not
the
only
citrus one, only. No. I mean, all of them are delicious, but this one.
Delicious. It would also taste really, really fucking good with vodka, I'm not gonna lie.
Or gin.
Ugh.
Okay, but it would taste good with gin. It's like super citrusy and like has kind of gingery background.
I want you to never talk to me about gin ever again because it's a disgusting alcohol. And you know how much I like alcohol. It's the only
Simone
alcohol.
Simone drinks gin.
Simone can be her beautiful self and drink that disgusting fucking poison if she wants to. But like, I will not partake in it. I will drink fucking champagne sometimes. And I'll drink other random things. But I will stick to my shitty vodka.
I like that you're still holding this.
What did you order?
Product placement. That was my back on the chair. No, I'm not farting.
She did.
Awesome. Shut up.
I'm joking. Okay, bye for now. I'm gonna get a lift.